Hello, I am Gapwin. This is Planet Explorers Creation Mode, and this is my Planet Explorers Holiday Special. And I hear some of you saying, Gapwin, you just did a Factorio holiday video. And to that I say, shut up, I can do two things. My channel. Anyway, I'm going to be doing a couple of holiday-themed builds. I'm planning to. We'll see how complicated each one turns out to be. And with any luck, we'll get both of them done in a very timely manner. So, I have created a creation object. We're doing large objects, and I went with fine. I've experimented with the different sizes, but I have honestly not experimented with the fine or rough versions enough to know. Let's see, 6x6 should be pretty good for the middle. Enough to know how much that will matter or not as far as the size of the thing. Anyway, we're going to start with this wooden bit in the middle. This is going to be a bit of a mystery build. Mystery build! We're going to make it out of wood, and there's nothing that I really want to use. I'm going to have to paint it. Let's go with marble, because why not marble? This one should be pretty easy. I want to kind of do it backward, just to make sure I have enough room to make it and things, and that I can make it look right. You may be able to guess what I'm making after this first couple of... Come on, 8x8, after these first couple of bits here. With the cones. Nah, that cone is too small to start. We'll start with a 10x10 cone on top. Like this. Then I really do want to put in parts. We've got all these new lights. Let's put in a point light right at the top there. Ah, it is not even. That's what this tool is for, though. There we go. That's right in the middle. Low intensity, and I want it to be kind of a goldish color and not visible. Apply. There we go. Now let's bring this down a little bit to about here-ish. I'm going to be... what was I using? Marble? I'm going to be kind of playing with how far down each of these tiers has to go and how much further out. And things of that nature. This is 2 squares in, so 16x16. And we'll see what starts looking right. Okay, that looks pretty good for that bit. This next bit should be a little bit lower and wider. It just needs to keep getting wider as we go down. So that last one was 2 out. Let's start at that corner on this new outer square. Whoop, that is way too big. There we go, 22x22. And make sure we bring it up properly. It should clip pretty well into the cone above it. And if you haven't guessed what I'm making now, I'm certainly not going to spoil it for you. If you have been able to, not tell at this point, you deserve the surprise. Is that actually bigger than the one below? Yes, it is. Okay, we need to clip in. That's looking pretty good. Very good. This, as I said, very simple build. I wanted to do a pretty simple one. Just to make, do a quick one, get into kind of the holiday spirit. I think I am going to add a little bit at the bottom, just to make sure, 34x34, and then, come on, like that, no. I do still want the 34x34, 32x34, nope, that's 32x32 now, let's try that, right, and 32. 33x32, you dolt. No, 32x32, and down a little bit. There we are. There we are. Those last two are the same. Dang it. Should be 34x34. There we go. That's 2 blocks larger than the one below. I'm sorry if I can't come up with as interesting of commentary, but as like I said, very simple build. I'm gonna get into a teeny bit. There we are. That looks nice. I enjoy that with the wood on the bottom, and just since the bottom looks a bit strange right now, I don't know. You know what? I'm gonna leave it up a bit, like that. I can't decide. Now we'll take it down. Yeah. We'll leave it like this. Then down at the bottom, let's see if we want to do anything with the bottom. Make a stand, maybe. Let's turn on XZ symmetry. Okay. Actually, turn off XZ symmetry for now. Kind of indecisive with that at the moment. We'll make this silver. We'll make a silver and gold kind of stand at the bottom here. Should be, is that 11? Out by 1. Yeah, out by 1. 12 by 12? Yeah, 12. I can't even see, but it's 9, 10, 11. 12 by... Come on. Come on, stop fighting me, camera. Stop fighting me. You will submit. 12 by 12. There we go. And up just slightly. Good, 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 good. Like that. And then default gold. Let's turn on symmetry. This can just be some wedges. I will take them out this direction. Come on. To do a stand. Very small. That very small stand. Tab. Tab. Yeah, that way and down. Like that. And then same on this side. Tab until the wedge is facing the correct direction. 2 by... Dang it, I didn't pay attention. Let's call it 4. And out. It looks like it's got kind of evil claws. But you know what? That works fine for Planet Explorers. Let's turn off symmetry. Hide the window. That bit's fine. That's the colors that I want. I need to go into paint. Find a kind of a dark green. Maybe a dark green. Paintbrush. Paint. Radius. Huge. And there we go. Let's... Oh, actually... You know what? Turn on symmetry. It helps paint. So then you only have to paint 1/4 of the thing. Look, it's kind of shiny too. It's like those fake ones from like the 70s. Super shiny and metal made of plastic. I'm glad that it keeps the shininess of the stone. It's really fun. Really fun. Oh, come on. Paint in there. Paint in that little bit. On the underhang, why won't you paint in there? Let's turn the radius down, see if I can get into that little part. Come on. Come on, fine, we'll turn symmetry off. Turn off symmetry and see if we can get in there? Not really. Let's turn the radius way down and see if we can get in there. A little more so. Anyway, the painting, I think it works terribly. Let's turn this back on. Turn the radius up. I want to make sure that we don't accidentally hit the trunk or the stand. There we go. It's not like you can see underneath it anyway. And we got a little bit in there. And on the... Ooh, dang it. And on the other side. See, I slipped. Gotta be careful. Thankfully, in this game, the undo command is very easy to get to. Alright, turn symmetry off. Hide window. Let's go back to materials. Gold. Circles. I want some gold circles. Just a couple of little ones. Alright, just a couple here and there. That should be a little bit below some of these. To make 4 by 4. Oh god, that doesn't look like a gold circle at all. Okay, part 2. I can't make them that tiny without problems. We'll put some random light sources around here. Hey. Just a few. There we go. Our parts. Good. I want all of these. I think I should... No, I have to change them all. Alright. Let's turn the intensity way down. These ones can be sort of a... That can be sort of a red. This one can be another kind of red. Oop, I need to turn the visibility down. Change the color. Change the color, turn down the intensity, and hit apply on all of these, because, yeah, I apply, Model visible. At least it'll make it easy to tell which ones I've done and which ones I haven't. I'm partial to blue lights. That's a personal thing. I hope that these do not wind up way too bright, because otherwise, you know, this thing is not going to be look-at-able in-game. No, green lights don't show up well on a green object. We should really know that. Sort of a sickly orange. Now let's go to the pink side. Intensity way down. Intensity way down. Let's do a blue one down there, and maybe like this one. Another pink one. Alright. That's pretty done. This spot's looking a little bare. Looking a little bare over here. Let's add a couple more lights. Why not? Oop, and that model should not be visible. Model visible. Apply. There. This one down, and this one should be up a bit and in. Yeah, like that. Good. Let's make this one sort of a reddish purple. Way down and apply, and this one kind of a... and apply. Oop, I don't want it to be white. Apply. There we go. Like I said, that was quick, but don't worry, we got... I said two. I'm thinking I might do a third build for this one, but that should go pretty quick. Pretty quick, just a third build. Let's be sure to save, and then we'll put them all in-game, you know, after the fact and together. Let's get it like that. We will give it a more appropriate background, sort of a white, you know, white snow color. Why not? Capture, and then we'll call this tree, because we have been making a Christmas tree, as I'm sure you were able to guess. I think it turned out pretty well. We'll see it in game in a minute. Next, we're going to make something else incredibly simple. Object large. Small or large? Let's do small and fine then on this one. Now, I want to be sure. No, I'll do it this way anyway. This way anyway. We'll start with wood. This is going to be a very, very simple one to build. We'll start with a wood kind of block about like that. I think that's working out. We will then grab some silver. We'll turn on our symmetries. Whoops. Turn on our symmetries for the silver. Go in a two line like that, and then a line going down the side like that. Same here. Oop, come on. Come on, you dastardly machine. Like that, and then another on the side. Come on. Alright, drag. Which direction will you let me drag? There we are. Like so. Good, let's turn off the Z. Keep the X. This bit is going to be difficult to do. I'm thinking of using... Let's use ovals. Alright, let's make sure the ovals are going in the proper direction that we want. We'll make them too wide, we'll make them out a little bit, and then kind of a squished... like that? No. Undo. Undo. Let's think about this. How are we going to get a bow? You all knew where this was going. How are we going to get a bow here? Okay, what I want to do is elevate this slightly, very slightly. Yeah, elevate this very slightly. Give us the two. Come on, give us two and go over enough. Still have it a bit squished. But I don't want it to be touching like that. So, yep, stop that. Stop it. Two and over a little more so that we can make it bigger, and then up a couple. Still too high. Let's cut the difference here. Sorry, this is taking longer than I expected. You know what, the original is fine. Let's two way out there and up like that. Yeah, that looks pretty fine. Let's go into paint. We'll make this bit kind of a, I don't know, red, darker red, not super saturated. Brush, huge. Now you may be asking yourself, why are you not just using the select paint? It's a habit that I got into. It's fine when you are not worried about your materials, like you're gonna put it in creative or something, but select paint actually paints, we'll make this sort of a lightish blue, like that. The select paint will actually paint every side of your, there you go, will paint every single side of your voxel instead of just the outside of the voxel. See, if you are able to cut this neatly after the fact, you'd be able to see the insides of these voxels do not have any coloring on them. And that may not seem very significant, but it means that you're using less pigment. So when you're making this in a non-creative mode, dang it, or non-build mode, you will be able to make it with fewer bits of pigment than if you were just to select and color. Because if you select and color, it colors all the sides of the voxel instead of just the, this bit I hate, trying to color match. All right, that's close enough. They need a eyedropper tool in this game, they really do. So it tries to, whoops, come on. Tries to color all four sides of the voxel instead of just the ones that are visible to you. And that is why I use the paintbrush instead of the select color, even though in some places like this, the select color might be a little easier. Come on. Dang it. I need to be very careful when I'm doing this. You know what? I'm not going to be super careful on this. I might do a slightly cleaned up one if I decide to try to put this on the ISO site or something. There we go. This doesn't need any objects, so we're just going to save this one. Alright, zoom in. Call this one present. Present. Save. Now, finally, last bit. Large. We're going with fine again. I made a lot of Christmas stuff, but this is not a Christmas special. This is a holiday special. We're going to make this one out of default gold. We're going to start with a large base. Let's go with a 20 by 20 base. Oops, I forgot to elevate it at all. I don't want just a disc. Well, with the 20 to 20 base, elevate it very slightly. Then we go with our columns here, 6 by 6. I want to tab it so that it's going the right frickin' direction. Go up a bit. There we are. Now, now we need to figure out what we're doing for the arms on this thing. I'm thinking we should use our cones. What are these things? Triangles? You know, one of those words. I want to turn on Z-symmetry. I want to keep Z-symmetry on from this point forward, probably. Want to drag this out a decent ways up. And then we just tabbed. We got the dang thing going the right direction. Oh, I should have given it a little bit of width. As they say, a little bit of width goes a long way. Nobody says that. Nobody says that. Nobody should say that. It sounds kind of dirty. And this is not a, this is a holiday special. It's not supposed to be dirty. Not at all. All right, let us drag this across and let's do that just slightly better. All right, I'm not liking how thick the middle of that has gotten. I want this to look a little bit delicate. I need to turn off symmetry for this. 4x4. 4x4 should look quite a lot better. There we are. Hide the window. Then we want this to be two. X side. I want this to be, what, two? Come on. Let's start. Turn the symmetry back on. Otherwise I'll have to do this twice. Come on, tab, 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 tab. There we are. And I want it to be that big. I want it to be in the middle this time. Let's get it out wide enough and up high enough. And it needs to be... Wow. Wow, that was a misclick. That was a heck of a misclick. Definitely sorry that this is going a little bit badly. I actually didn't think about this one as much ahead of time. It occurred to me when I was planning out this series a little. There we go. There we go. Now, just need... Alright, a central bit here. Bring this up so that we can make our spires easily. On the edge, let's make these 4x4. And actually, let's see if we can do a 2x2 that looks good. Yes, 1, 2. I need to make sure that I space these evenly. It's a 2x2. By something. How many is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's gonna be a little too far apart, isn't it? And then 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, just a little bit. Well, there's those, and then a 2x2 that's a little bit higher. That's way too high. No, it's gonna be a 2x2 that's a little bit taller. Like that. Like that. I think that looks pretty. I like it. You can complain if you want, but I enjoy it. I enjoy it, and it's my holiday special. Now, parts. Point lights. Turn the danged. I actually don't keep the symmetry on for this. I want to put one in the middle. Yep, and then now we turn the symmetry back on. Hide the window. We want one on each of these. None of those is lined up correctly, is it? Very difficult to tell. Because, yeah, just very difficult to see on this. Because these are weird colors. Alright, like that. And like that. They all should be lined up. Okay, let's make these a nice kind of orangey gold fire color. Turn the intensity down, turn the model off. And just the same along the line. Unfortunately, they're not all going to be the same color because there's not really a copy-paste. I've looked, it just doesn't really exist. They had this color up here. Intensity down. We're almost done. Model visible, apply. There we go. Almost done. Intensity down, model visible, and apply. And we'll leave the intensity of that one a little higher. And apply. There we go. All done. Let's save and export all these. Save. Why is it sideways? Stop being in a weird place. Cache of the picture. I'm very sorry if my spelling on this is really weird. Etc. I have no idea how to spell English or any other language. Save successful. All right, I'm going to jump in to my creative mode, and we're going to just show all these off. Nice little scene. I'll set up a nice little scene for you. I'll see you there in a minute. All right, I had to change a couple things because apparently you're not allowed to have more than 4 lights on things, which kind of, you know, leaves the menorah right out of luck. Sorry about that. I didn't realize that. Also, the gold texture appears to have turned plaid on me. Don't know what's going on with that. It seems to be reflecting okay. Anyway, that one didn't turn out well, unfortunately. This one did, and so did all my little things here. Unfortunately, it's not a very white holiday, because, you know, in the middle of a jungle. But I think it all turned out okay. Also, a little note, this is turned on. Alright, there are a few lights on there, but if you don't have them visible, it just makes things brighter in an area. I thought there might be some kind of bloom effect or something. It just makes things a little brighter. If you want to actually see it, you need to make the lights visible, which is what I did on the tree here. Which I think works as ornament balls. I don't think it would have worked on this end. This would only had four lights anyway. And I'm not sure which day of Hanukkah it is, so I have no idea if that would be appropriate or not. Figured I'd just go with the blank one rather than messing with the lights there. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. I know it's not quite as interesting as some other builds that I've done, but I thought it was a little bit festive. And I just wanted to wish you all a happy holidays. I hope you're having fun with whatever you choose to do this winter. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, you can leave a like. If you really enjoyed and want to see more, you can subscribe. I am Gepwin. I hope you have a wonderful holiday season, and I'll see you soon.